I want you to look at Genesis chapter 1, beginning at verse number 1. We're going to read through verse number 4, and then we're going to jump down to verse number 14. Is that all right? It reads like this, and I believe I'm in the King James tonight. If I'm not, y'all forgive me. Yeah, I'm in the New King James, that's fine.
Oh, God.
record this tonight, and somebody's going to need this after this. Ladies and gentlemen, I need you to understand, what I've walked through these last few days was the outcome I should have lost my mind. We stood in the back last night, the pastors and leaders, we stood in the back last night, and we talked together, and I can share with them some of the things that I have been walking through. And I was being transparent with them. Let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. There are some things that will hit your life that are unexplainable. There are some things that will hit your life that no amount of religiosity can give you an answer to. You've done all the formulas, you've done all this that you know to do, you pray, you fasted, you worship, you cry out to God, but there are some pains, some difficulties, some struggles, some trouble, some things that will happen in your life that literally nothing that you have done, none of your steps seem to have worked. Now, tonight,
if somebody introduces
when we hit moments like this, for those of now let me go a little further, because then, Pastor Swinger, there's another theological debate of whether in the text, the 7 days that God created the heaven and earth in, whether it was a literal 7 days,
yeah,
or whether it was a figurative 7 days. Do you understand what I mean when I say that? Whether it was actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
yeah,
or was it a period of time represented? Because you know when you have the scripture says a day with the Lord is as 1,000 years. So there are people who question whether there were periods of time between these days when God created. Are y'all with me so far?
Oh,
This is what you gotta do. And so, before I can even tell him, he goes and gets that worship song. There is power in the name of Jesus. And he starts playing. And he starts singing. Next thing I know, the panic attack starts settling down. But the warfare was going. So by the time while chaos was going on. Did y'all read when I read? It said, but the Spirit of God.
Yes.
Y'all gonna talk right there? Doing it. not be there. But God said, let.
Yeah.
Which means allow. Permit. Which means you can no longer hinder what's up here from manifesting down there. Y'all should have called me right there. I said, God declared, you, darkness, can no longer hinder what is up here from manifesting down there. What am I trying to tell you? That tonight, for somebody, you might be in chaos right now, but I hear in my ear a word from God declaring to somebody that what's up here is about to be revealed down there. But I'm here, he's up in the earth as he is in heaven. Yes! Thy will be done or revealed down here like it is up there. Somebody, do me a favor. I'm about to get ready to close this in just a minute. But do me a favor and sign this holler. There's about to be a breakthrough.
See him as he is.
Am I making sense to somebody tonight? The reason why some of y'all get nervous is because you weren't being printed to the blueprint.
Go ahead.
What you said wrong? I said that you didn't get a glimpse at the blueprint. And because you didn't get a glimpse at the blueprint, and everything is in chaos right now, it makes it a little bit difficult because you don't know what it's going to look like in the end. But you got to say, all pretty. When he puts the steel scripture specifically says the greater and the lesser life. Referring to the sun and the moon. Why, preacher, do your feet feel light? Because what God is doing to break through your chaos is defying what makes sense. Y'all miss me.
Be wrong with you.
Let them point me to Jesus.
Yes.
So,
how do I find out the kingdom? Can you find any kings?
No.
Is there anybody here who you're dealing with some chaos right now? Let me see your hand. Dealing with some chaos.
Why did they put them on the I need to go. He was walking with me. He was talking with me. Taking me. Moving obstacles. Y'all missed that. Y'all missed it. That door right there was in the way. Lord, I'll preach that right there. That door was open. But it wasn't the door I needed to walk in.
Back in the same place.
Yeah.
It's easier for me to come and talk to the family than it is for me to press in and go talk to God. It's easier for me to call mama and tell mama my problems.
Yeah.
I'm talking to somebody up here. It's easier for me to call your best friend, your boo, your confidant, your babe. So instead of you come back down to what's comfortable for you.
Now this is February, please.
The Lord says tonight, everything in your environment will no longer be able to be comfortable for you. God says, I'm upsetting everything. Preach, you won't declare blessings. I am declaring blessings. If he upsets everything for you, let me talk about
the angel something.
When the eagle gets big enough and it's not letting the eagle fly, the mother stirs up the nest and causes the twigs that were comfortable for that eagle, causes those twigs to stick up so that eagle will no longer be comfortable in the nest that it's been in. So what I'm trying to tell you, for some of you, watch this. The ego does not reveal its full potential until it spreads its wings and gets out of the way. Y'all should have said amen right there. It does not get its full potential or display its full potential until it's up there doing this. So God is actually blessing you when he upsets some stuff in your life.
Yeah.
Because now, it's making you spread your wings.
Yeah.
And if I'm spread my wings, I can't stay with nothing I've been on. I gotta go high. And it seems like God's still not close. I just gotta keep going. Tonight, that was you.